Hi, this is Carolyn from the 1940s experiment, and today I'm going to recreate a wartime recipe from Feeding the Nation cookbook by Marguerite Patton. I'm going to recreate what's called padded pudding, and essentially that's made with stale breadcrumbs, custard and jam. So the main ingredient of padded pudding is stale bread, which is really economical. It calls for a teacup of stale breadcrumbs. So this has been languishing on top of the fridge for a few days and needs using up. So the easiest way to do it is rip 3 or 4 slices of bread up and whiz it around in the blender just for a few moments. I'm using whole wheat bread. There's no blue bits on it, it'd be absolutely fine. So there's the breadcrumb, simple, just make sure you tear it up into small pieces, and you need about a teacupful. So after we've made the breadcrumbs, the next thing to do is to make a pint of custard sauce. I've just used bird's custard, 2 tablespoons, mixed with a tablespoon of sugar, and make that into a paste with a little bit of milk. I'm using some milk. So when you've made your pint of custard, you then need to add your breadcrumbs, your jam and your vanilla essence. So you continue mixing it for 5 minutes. It's not the most pleasantest of colours, I have to say, especially with the whole wheat breadcrumbs, but you know what? People were hungry during the war and you wouldn't have wasted ingredients. So while I'm waiting for the padded pudding to cool, I need to make the mock cream. During World War II, they didn't really have fresh cream unless you lived on a farm, so what they did was they made their own mock cream substitute, and this is made out of 1 ounce of margarine, 1 ounce of sugar, a couple of tablespoons of dried milk, and a little bit of milk to mix it together. So I'm going to do that now, and when the padded pudding is cool enough, I'll put that in the jars and we'll top it with the mock cream and even a little bit of grated chocolate. I wonder if a cook during the 1940s would have ate the little chunky bits left on the end. I'm not told anybody. I don't know. I'm supposed to be losing weight here. It's very difficult. I love chocolate. Chocolate! So the padded pudding is ready. I thought it would kind of look pink. It actually looks brown and doesn't look that great, but I'm not going to waste it. I kind of feel like Mrs. Cropley off the Vicar of Dibley. If you look into my saucepan, you'll know what I mean. It's very interesting. But I'm following Marguerite Patton's recipes to the tea, so I'm sure hers looked hideous and brown too. So now it's time for the mock cream, which hopefully will be the saviour of this dish and make it look a little bit more appetising. The mock cream doesn't look too bad, actually. As for the padded pudding, less said the better. Right, so there we have it. I've made 6 pots of padded pudding with a mock cream top and even a little bit of grated chocolate. I guess the proof of the pudding is in the eating. Actually, it's not bad. In fact, it's quite nice. Okay, I think I shall retire to my boudoir. See you later. Bye. Some sunny day.